And now, I'm so excited, I'm here with Sacha Gervasi, the director, the first-time director, it's unbelievable that this is your first feature film, of Hitchcock, one of my favorite films of the year. I've already seen it twice.
Oh my
I could
God,
see it
thank
again.
You.
I can't wait.
But more importantly, will you pay next time? Have you paid?
Well, I have to think about
okay,
that.
Okay, good. I'll give you the money. I just want the satisfaction of knowing a ticket has been bought.
Well, I think you're going to have quite a success with this film. And I'm, you probably don't know this, but I'm the Oscar messenger. Tom Hooper named me the Oscar messenger.
Is that true?
So, yes, and I'm here. That's why I'm here.
My God, you're the Oscar messenger.
Yes, I'm
here. Hooper's Oscar messenger.
Yes, and I'm here to give you the Oscar message, Sasha. I think you're best actor and best actress will get nominated, Sir Anthony Hopkins and Dame Helen Mirren, and best picture?
Listen,
I'd vote for it.
I mean, for us, it's an extraordinary experience because it was such an impossible thing to get the film made, and we had to do it very quickly with no money. We went from the beginning of shooting to the finished film in 6 months because it had this tremendous energy. It had Tony and Helen so passionate about making it, and I think hopefully that comes, clearly it's coming across in the film.
Well, I'm not able to speak to them today, so you'll have to speak for Helen and Tony yourself. So
right.
Tell me about their passion.
Well, I think that Tony had wanted to play the role for some time. It had been around for about 8 or 9 years and had gone through several incarnations. Finally, I came on board. Tony Hopkins was a huge fan of a movie I'd made called Anvil. And so
I loved it.
Well, thank you. And because of that film, I had the opportunity both with Tony Hopkins and Tom Pollock, our producer, and Ivan Reitman to basically have a chance to direct this film. And then Helen, too, it turned out, was also a fan of Anvil, bizarrely. And I think that they saw
that Helen.
So basically, there was this sense of we're on a mission. We want to tell the story of this incredible relationship that most people do not know about.
I knew everything there was to know about it. I'm a Hitchcock.
So you know.
I was crazy about Alma Reville ever since I first.
Amazingly
met.
Stylish, brilliant, so wonderfully humble, and such a huge resource to Hitchcock, and an integral part of his creative process, and ultimately a decision maker.
He couldn't do anything without her.
That's right.
He ran everything by her.
That's
ladies
right.
and gentlemen, she wrote a lot of the films,
edited
them,
absolutely.
And took no credit.
And didn't want it, and she was just happy for her husband's genius to be enhanced by whatever her efforts were. And I think that's that great Hitchcock quote, I would rather not do a film without her. You know, he didn't want to make anything without her because he trusted her. So I think that was the story that generally you know, obviously, as an aficionado.
Well, her daughter, who's still alive...
Wrote the book,
I'm sure you read it. Janet Lee wrote a book.
That's right, and acknowledged Alma, too.
Everybody loved Alma Reville, who is played by so beautifully by Helen, Dame Helen Mirren.
She's extraordinary. And to see Anthony Hopkins and Helen Mirren together working for the first time.
But there's no daughter in that. Was that a decision?
Well, no, it wasn't a decision. Pat was out of the house by this point. She was in her late 20s.
She had two children.
Right. If you know the story, it actually adds another layer because it's about empty nesters. left with themselves. So it's very interesting. Obviously, you know the detail. But for us, she was sort of not part of the story because she was gone already.
But she was in Psycho for
a minute. In the Lowry office. She was the secretary complaining about talking with her mother on the phone. Absolutely.
About taking tranquilizers
on her
wedding night. I wonder if Alma put that in there.
Alma probably put that in there again.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Anyway, they're giving me the wind-up sign. Sasha, I could talk to you for hours.
Well, just one more question. We should do one more.
One more question?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I mean, so yes, Patricia was out of the house.
Yeah.
And the book, book.
Well, that book that Patricia Hitchcock wrote up. What's wonderful is Helen Mirren said a very interesting thing. She said it's funny that the single child of Alfred and Alma Hitchcock chose to write a book about her mother and called it the story of Alma Reville.
The woman behind the man.
So
well, there you go.
Pat was the first one telling us, and I think
she loved her mother.
She loved her mother.
She had issues with her father, as did everybody.
As did everybody.
Got a father like that.
That's right. That's right. Very complicated, but wonderful and brilliant. And I think we've hopefully honored them in this film.
You sure have.
And honored the spirit of this incredible woman who people don't know, who for so long has been in the shadows, but who really deserves recognition, as you know, for the contributions that she made, which were massive.
To world cinema. She was a major figure. And finally, through this beautiful movie, Hitchcock, and you know you're going to rush out and see it, because it's so delightful and it's funny, too.
Yeah,
it's droll. When do you see wit? When do you see droll film? I mean...
Well, we try to sort of embrace it the Hitchcock spirit. We wanted it to be in his style. And that was really important to do it. Well, we felt justice to
And it
to
was what, adorable, too.
Well, I thank you so much.
And so moving. So I just had to move you all on to the Dolby Pavilion to get some Oscars. I'm sure you're going to get nominated.
I will be at
the
Oscars, but I'm actually apparently parking cars. So I'm going to be second in charge of the valet. I will be there, but in that capacity.
Right. Anyway, Sasha, thank you so much. Pleasure.